Welcome to session 7 of biasing in MOS amplifier circuits. In the previous session we have seen a particular type of biasing method by fixing gate voltage, and that circuit has a voltage divider bias formed by RG1 and RG2 resistors, as well as there was an RD resistor as well as RS resistor. So in this session we are going to take one example to understand how designing of such a biasing circuit can be done, and also so we will take one more biasing circuit using drain to gate feedback resistor. So to begin with, consider this example. So here in this problem, it is required to establish a DC drain current of 0.5 milliamperes. Okay, so it means we want an ID of 0.5 milliamperes, and the MOSFET is specified to have certain specifications like threshold voltage VT equal to 1 volt and that process constant Kn dash W by L equal to 1 milliampere per volt square. So and also this lambda channel length modulation factor is kept equal to 0, so we need not worry about that. And the circuit uses a power supply of 15 volts. So therefore now what we need to do is calculate the percentage change in the value of drain current obtained when the MOSFET is replaced by another unit having the same Kn dash W by L value but threshold voltage VT equal to 1.5 volts. Okay. So now in this particular problem, we need to calculate a new value of drain current when threshold voltage VT is changed to 1.5 volts. So initially already we need to design a circuit where a drain current ID equal to 0.5 milliamperes is required. But later on, whenever the MOSFET is replaced by another MOSFET having threshold 1.5 volts, then what is the new value of drain current that is possible in the circuit, that we need to find out. Now the circuit diagram is as shown. So here we need to determine what is RG1, RG2 as well as RD and RS values. So now as well as we can calculate the biasing voltage, that is VG also here. Okay, and here one design rule is used, like VDD, 1/3 of the VDD is made to drop across RD as well as VDS and RS. Okay, so therefore at VD we have 10 volts. Okay, so at VD we have 10 volts. Okay, and at VS it will be equal to 5 volts. So therefore with this we will next calculate what are RS and RD values. Now the expression for RD is RD is equal to VDD minus VD by ID. So VDD is 15 volts minus VD is 10. VD is 10 volts, this divided by, it is given that ID of 0.5 milliamperes is required, so therefore this gives us 10 kilo ohms. Similarly, RS is equal to, it is source voltage, VS divided by ID, so VS is 5 volts and drain current ID is 0.5 milliamperes, so this is going to give us RS value of 10 kilo ohms again. Okay, so now these are the RD and the RS values. So now later on we are going to calculate the remaining parameters like VG. Okay, so but to calculate VG we also need gate to source voltage VGS, so which is available from the drain current equation. So therefore let us now write the drain current equation ID, that is equal to half Kn dash W by L into V OV whole square. Okay. So in this equation, the term VOE will be equal to VGS minus VT, that is VGS minus threshold voltage VT. So we will calculate VGS with the help of this equation, call it as equation A. Okay. okay, by substituting the given parameters. So therefore, now ID is 0.5 milliamperes. So therefore, substitute ID 0.5, that is equal to half into Kn dash value, that will be equal to 1 into VOV pole square. So simplifying this, overdrive voltage, this is gate to source overdrive voltage, so this will be equal to 1 volt. Okay. So therefore, once VOV is available, we can now calculate what is the VGS value. Okay, so VGS, this is because VGS minus VT is nothing but VOV. Okay, so therefore VGS will be equal to VOV plus VT. So 1 volt plus threshold voltage is 1 volt. So VGS will be equal to 2 volts. Okay, so this is an important result where we have calculated the gate to source voltage value. Okay, so now as VS is equal to 5 volts. So why VS is equal to 5 volts? Because as a design rule, we have taken 5 volts across RS and remaining 5 volts across VDS, remaining 5 volts across RD. Okay, so that's why VS is equal to 5 volts. That is, 1/3 of the VDD is available as VS. Okay, so as VS is equal to 5 volts, now we can write what is the total VG that is available. So VG will be equal to VS plus VGS. So you can see in the circuit diagram. Okay, so VG will be equal to, so here we have VGS. Okay, and at this point, okay, so we have VS voltage. So this is VGS and then VS. The sum will be equal to VG. So VG is equal to, VS is 5 plus VGS is also 2 volts. So therefore VG will be equal to 7 volts. Okay, so now we have computed RD, RS, VGS and VG values. Okay, so VG is equal to 7 volts is an important result in this. Okay, so now we need to design RG1 and RG2. So we have to set up RG1 and RG2 registers such that our VG will be fixed at 7 volts. Okay, so to make it possible, so let us select RG1 is equal to 8 mega ohm and RG2 is equal to 7 mega ohms. So why RG1 is 8 and RG2 is 7 is, see, we know that VG is nothing but R G2 divided by RG1 plus RG2 into VDD. Okay, so RG2 is equal to 7 mega ohm, RG1 is 8 mega ohm plus this is 7 into 15 volts. Okay, so this 15, this 15 cancels. So therefore, again, we are able to get VG is equal to 7 volts. Okay, so that's why RG1 is 8 and RG2 is equal to 7 mega ohm, so that VG will be again fixed to 7 volts. So therefore, now the design of RG1, RG2, RD, RS is over. Now what is given in the problem is, when in the same circuit, if the given MOSFET is replaced by another MOSFET having a threshold voltage VT of 1.5 volts, then what is the new value of drain current? Okay, so we need to check by how much percentage the drain current is going to vary when threshold voltage of the device is going to change. So now this is possible by writing the drain current equation only. So therefore, we have the drain current equation given by ID equal to half into 1 into VGS minus VT. So now VT is 1.5, so I am directly writing 1.5 in the threshold voltage place. Okay, so this is one equation, call it as equation A. Similarly, we also have VG, that is equal to VGS plus ID into RS. So but VG is equal to 7 volts, this is equal to VGS plus 10 into ID. We will call it as A and B, equation B. Okay, so therefore now, so as threshold voltage itself is changing to 1.5 volts, so we will use equation A and B in order to calculate the new drain current. Okay, so from equation B, it is possible to write what is VGS. Okay, so from equation B, VGS is nothing but 7 minus 10 into ID. Okay, substituting this VGS in ID equation, okay, we can write ID equal to half into 7 minus 10 ID minus 1.5 whole square. Okay, so solving this equation, we are going to get a quadratic equation, which will be 100 ID square minus 112 ID plus 30.25, that is equal to 0. So the solution of this equation is going to give us the two values of drain current. Okay, so ID one value will be equal to 0.665 milliamperes, and other drain current value ID2 will be equal to 0.455 milliamperes. What are these two? These two are the two values of this quadratic equation. Okay, so now in this, which drain current we need to choose? So for that, we will calculate the gate to source voltage. Okay, so whichever is going to satisfy our VGS, then that will be our correct drain current. Okay, so now if we choose ID as 0.665 milliamperes, so then our VGS will be equal to 7 minus 10 into ID. So this is 7 minus 10 into ID will be 0.665 milliamperes. So therefore, for this, VGS comes to be 7 minus 6.6, approximately 0.4 volts. Okay, but this is not a correct value of VGS. So therefore, if we choose ID, okay, so if we choose an ID of 0.455 milliamperes, so then by using the same analogy, so VGS is going to be equal to around 2.5 volts. Okay, so therefore, for us, the drain current ID, that is equal to 0.455 milliamperes, is the correct value, and the new value of drain current, which is obtained when threshold value is changed to 1.5 volts. Okay, so therefore, now we need to find what is the percentage change in the drain current. Okay, so earlier it was 5 milliamperes, that is for VT is equal to 1 volt, drain current was 0.5 milliamperes. Okay, so now for VT equal to 1.5 volts, the drain current is 0.455 milliamperes. Okay, so therefore, delta ID, that is change in the drain current, is only minus 0.045 milliamperes. So the minus sign shows that it has reduced. Okay, so therefore, percentage change. So percentage change in drain current ID will be equal to, so this is minus 0.045 by the original current, that is 0.5 milliamperes, into 100. So with this will be equal to minus 9% change. Okay, so this is how we need to calculate the change in the drain currents whenever one MOSFET is replaced by another MOSFET having a different threshold voltage. Okay, so this is regarding the design of a biasing circuit, where biasing is done through fixing the VG. So now we have one more biasing techniques, which is nothing but biasing using drain to gate feedback resistor. So here this circuit is much more simple compared to the previous circuits. Components are also less. We have one drain resistor RD as well as a RG resistor, which is nothing but a very large feedback resistor connected between drain and the gate terminals. Okay, so the advantage of this is, okay, this particular arrangement, it will force the DC voltage at the gate terminal, DC voltage at the gate terminal to be equal to that of drain terminal. Okay, so thereby making this gate current IG is equal to zero. Okay, now for this particular setup, we can write the KVL like VDD equal to ID into RD plus this is the gate current into RG, that is current flowing through the resistor, IG into RG plus it is VGS voltage plus VGS. But as IG is equal to 0, so we have VDD equal to ID into RD plus VGS, that's all. Okay. Therefore, from this equation, it is possible to write what is VGS. So VGS will be simply VDD minus ID into RD. But this VGS is also equal to VDS because of this connection. As gate is connected back to drain, so VGS is equal to VDS, that is again equal to VDD minus ID into RD. Okay. So now this is the biasing technique, so which again tries to make or tries to stabilize the drain currents. Okay, so which are most required to fix the biasing point. So now an example to understand this biasing technique. So let us consider one simple example. So here it is given that design on this biasing circuit. So in order to operate at a DC drain current of 0.5 milliamperes, okay, and assume drain voltage of 5 volts and that process constant Kn dash W by L is given as previous problem, 1 milliamperes per volt square, and here threshold voltage of the MOSFET is 1 volt. Again that lambda parameter need not consider, that is 0 only. So now the next condition is use a standard 5% resistance value for RD and give the actual values obtained for ID and VD. Okay, so in this problem, first we need to calculate what is the RD value, and then we have to change that RD value to a standard 5% resistance value, and then we have to again recalculate what are ID and VD values. Okay, so that is when RD is changed, so how the drain current is going to change, in order to check that this design problem is given, that's all. Okay, so therefore in order to solve this particular problem, we need some simple drain current equations. So that is we have the equation for RD. Okay, so RD is equal to, so RD is equal to VDD minus VGS by ID. So this to calculate the drain current. Okay, so now initially with the given values we will find what is this RD value. So VDD is given as 5 volts minus VGS. So I think we need to calculate this VGS value divided by the drain current value, that is 0.5 milliamperes. But without VGS it is not possible to calculate RD. So therefore we have to first know how much is this VGS. So anyway, we have the drain current equation to calculate VGS. So ID in saturation mode, it is half Kn dash W by L into VOV square. So whenever VGS is not known, we need to use this only. Even though VOV is equal to VGS minus VT, you have to write in overdrive voltage form only. Okay, so then here substitute. So ID is 0.5 milliamperes, half into this value is 1 milliampere VOV square. Okay, so this is going to give us overdrive voltage as 1 volt. Okay, so but what is overdrive voltage? V overdrive is equal to VGS minus VT. So therefore we can write now VGS is nothing but V overdrive plus threshold voltage. Okay, so therefore now we can calculate VGS is nothing but V overdrive plus threshold voltage. So V overdrive voltage was 1 volt as we have calculated. It was equal to 1 volt plus threshold voltage of the device was given as 1 volt. So therefore VGS is equal to 2 volts. So now once VGS is available, now we will go back to this circuit and substitute here to calculate RD value. So RD is equal to 5 minus 2 volts divided by this 0.5 milliamperes. So this gives us 6 kilo ohms. Okay, 6 kilo ohms. Now in the problem it is given that, so use a standard 5% resistance value for RD. Okay, so from the table of the resistance, so 5% RD, okay, so 5% standard resistance is 6.2 kilo ohms. This value will be available from the table of resistors. Okay, so we need to replace now 6 kilo ohms by 6.2 kilo ohms, and now we have to calculate what are the actual values of drain current and the drain voltage. Okay, so now we will calculate how much is the drain current value. So ID is now, so we have to just interchange the terms in this equation. Okay, so ID will come on the LHS, VDD minus VGS divided by RD. Okay, so VDD is 5 volts minus VGS is 2 volts by RD. So RD is now, it is 6.2 kilo ohms. 6.2 kilo ohms. So this is going to give us 0.48 milliamperes of drain current. Okay, so actually earlier it was 0.5 milliamperes when RD was 6 kilo ohms. Okay, so now its value is reduced to 0.48 milliamperes. So therefore now we have to calculate what is the VD. Where is actually VD? VD is, we have to calculate this point, okay, at the drain terminal. So therefore VD will be equal to VDD minus ID into RD. So 5 minus, now it is 0.48 milliamperes into RD value 6.2 kilo ohms. Milli and kilo, they will cancel. So VD is equal to, that is approximately 2.02 value you can calculate. Okay, so these are the actual values of drain current and the drain voltage, and this is the solution of the problem. Okay, so therefore in this session we have seen designing the two biasing circuits. So whenever their parameters are changed, so how the drain current and drain voltages are going to change. Okay, so we will continue some more topics in the next session. Thank you.